We begin with breaking news. A former Cincinnati reverend and civil rights leader, one of the most beloved in the country, has died. And News 5's Curtis Fuller looks at the life of Fred Shuttlesworth.
To have a war against injustice, not against people, war against injustice, war against any system that sets up a thing where a man cannot be, cannot become.
For 70 years, he was a driving force in the civil rights movement, always fighting to make things better for all citizens.
Here's a man that many historians say today made Dr. King the man that he was.
Former Cincinnati Mayor Dwight Tillery talked to me about his friend, Fred Shuttlesworth.
He was part of what was known the Big Three, Dr. King, Reverend Abernathy, and Reverend Shuttlesworth. All those folks really had a great impact on me as a young person because I came through during the civil rights movement. And the whole issue of injustice is something that is very troubling for me. And it doesn't matter what color the person is. It's very troubling for me to see people in society be unjust to other people. It's a very troubling matter for me.
We witnessed Reverend Shuttlesworth overcoming everything from his house being bombed to fighting off dogs and water hoses in Birmingham.
The Ku Klux Klan tried to blow me into heaven, blow me away. But you don't kill leaders. You don't kill the idea if you kill the person. But God saved me because he had to have somebody to go through a spectacular demonstration of his power to live in Birmingham. And when it detective said to me, he said, if I were you, I'd get out of town as quick as I could. I said, well, the officer, you're not me. And you go back and tell your Klan brother that if God could save me through this, I'm here for the duration, and the war is on.
Former Ohio lawmaker William Mallory Sr.
We have to understand that he was fearless. He risked his life so many times get rid of injustice and discrimination and cruel treatment of people. Where he got that courage from, I don't know.
Reverend Shuttlesworth came to Cincinnati in 1961, and in the past few years, he retired from the pulpit at Greater New Light Baptist Church. He was a fearless civil rights fighter who worked side by side with Martin Luther King Jr.
King did not want to be the only one, nor do I. We live to glorify Christ. We live to better the life that Christ came and died to give us by teaching men how to love, how to give, how to forgive.
They were change agents that forced an end to segregation.
But I always felt about him that he had this sense of fairness, didn't show kind of jealousy and competitiveness in spite of all the great things that this man has done. So it's really quite a remarkable person.
Well, thanks to Curtis Fuller for that. But in recent years, Shuttlesworth, well, he has been in bad health. He died in a hospital, we're told, in Birmingham, Alabama. He was surrounded by family and friends. He was 89 years old. Our condolences to them.